contributed $139 million to the Division of Children and Family Services. That money goes towards taking care of kids in foster care or who need supervised visits. The money we give has gone up over the years, but the results haven't. 4029's Kelly Johnson talked to a former DHS worker who says the system is broken in this 4029 News investigation.
I love you, Mom. Come to my room tonight. Wake me up if I'm asleep. This note was stuck on the front door. It had been left there by her son that had not seen his mom for 3 to 4 days.
Vicki Robinson is a former DCFS worker. She's reading a note that was given to a co-worker from that woman's own son, who missed his mom so much because she was working so many hours. And there's irony there. Workers are forced to do so much to keep other families together that their own fall apart.
I was so weary of putting in 70 to 80 hours a week, and that's what's required of you in order to keep your head above water.
Every time DCFS loses a worker like Vicki, they take a big hit. Turnover is sky high. Right now, their vacancy rate is almost 25%. That's 227 open positions in the state. And that is the root of the problem. This February, the average caseload for a DCFS worker in Washington County was 51. That's more than 3 times higher than what the max should be. That cap was set by a judge in a 1991 lawsuit settlement.
50 cases might mean 80 children, 100 parents.
The area of the state with the highest caseloads per worker is our area. Benton, Madison, Washington, and Carroll counties averaged 43 cases per worker in February. And the River Valley was right behind with an average of 40 in August. And in fact, one of the workers had 98 cases that month.
So let's take a look at a breakdown of some of the state's compliance numbers. In 2012, DCFS workers had 30 days after a report of child abuse was filed to complete a report. That happened 64% of the time. Caseworkers are also supposed to be visiting with their children in foster care once a month. Last year, that happened 60% of the time. And children who needed a health screening within 24 hours of first entering the system got it 67% of the time.
Really heartbreaking to see the future that some of these children have.
Mary Alice Hasselbein is an attorney who's been representing kids in the system for more than 3 decades. And for as many success stories as she's seen, there have also been plenty of kids who don't make it.
They are not prepared for adult responsibilities. They become homeless. They pick up criminal charges and they wind up going to prison.
4029 went to Little Rock, and when we asked the director of DCFS if her department even tries to keep the caseloads at 15, she said,
not really.
But Cecile Blucher did recognize there is a systemic problem in the system that needs addressed.
I do recognize that it's an issue, and so we're just trying to find the ways that will help us address that.
A caseload of 50 is too much for one worker. There are things that are going to fall through the cracks.
Now, during our trip to Little Rock, the DCFS director shared with us a new program that they're hoping will be the solution to the problem. It's ambitious, and we're one of the first states in the country to try it out. Tune in to 4029 News Sunday night to find out what it is.
Kelly Johnson reporting. Now, you can see that second part of the investigation Sunday night on the Arkansas CW at 9 p.m. and on 4029 News at 10.
New information tonight.